And so many countries had, or so many different regions had now entered into the governorate of the Muslims, from amongst them parts of Russia and Cyprus, Armenia and North Africa. So more and more areas of people had accepted Islam under the leadership of Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu. He was a person who had written the Quran, or got it written, in one dialect. Because at that time, as you know, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu had appointed Zayd ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu to gather the Quran. He gathered it and they gave a copy to Hafsa, who was the wife of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the daughter of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhuma. So what happened is, Uthman ibn Affan, he received a complaint from Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman that I've been to different areas and people are reading the Arabic language in a different dialect. So why don't we sort the problem out? So Uthman ibn Affan appointed Zayd ibn Thabit once again, with him a few others, and told them, get the written parchments from Hafsa binti Umar radiallahu anha and write it down. We want it in one script. So they wrote it in one script. They got hold of all the others and they did away with them. And he sent a copy of this script to all the different parts of the Muslim lands. And he told them, this is now the final version. This is what you will follow. At that time, there were no dots. You know, you have two dots on top of the ta, two under the ya, one in the jim. No dots at all. It was just written. Their Arabic was so powerful, they knew how to read it. So what happened is, it cut down the difference of opinion completely regarding the dialects in which the Quran should be read. To this day, we have the Quran that we have in our midst written in what is known as Ar-Rasmul Uthmani, which means the writing that was confirmed by Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu. This was one of the great achievements of Uthman ibn Affan.